Brother Anthony Roberts, greeting you from the five gospel halls here in Tobago. We are delighted that you've been able to join us for today's program, Moments with Truth. We are praying that as you view this program, that you will receive a blessing from the Lord. For those who are not saved, we are praying very specially that you will receive the Lord Jesus as your Savior, even today, as you hear the Word of God. And for those of you who are saved, it is our prayer that you will be built up on your most holy faith as you view the Word of God.
Shall we seek the Lord's face in prayer? Shall we pray? Our Father in heaven, we gladly approach thee this day in the name of thy Son, our Lord and our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. We worship thee and thank thee for this opportunity we have in this island, in this country, to open thy word without any hindrances from those in authority. We have enjoyed this freedom over the many years, and we pray that this will continue until traveling days are over. And so we pray this day, as we shall open thy word and speak of that one who is mighty to save, that thou wilt grant the help of which we stand in need. Thy word will be declared very simply, yet with power, that everyone who sits, everyone who listens, will not only understand the issues and the truths that will be brought before them, but the Spirit of God will convict them of their sin, of righteousness, and of thy judgment to come. And every sinner who is not thine will repent and trust Christ as Savior and be saved before it is forever too late. So we commit ourselves to thee. We ask for thy help and for thy blessing. Again, we pray for those who are not well. Father, we pray that thou wilt heal, restore to a sense of normalcy, and we will give thee all the honor, the praise, and the glory. These things we ask with our thanksgiving through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Today, I would like us to turn to the prophecy of Isaiah chapter 1 and verse number 18. The prophecy of Isaiah chapter 1 and verse number 18. The word of God says, "Come now, and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool." Shall we read that verse again, please? Isaiah chapter 1 and verse 18. "Come now, and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool." We trust and we know that God will bless the public reading of his word to our hearts and speak to us therefrom for Christ's sake. Amen. Today I would like us to consider as our subject, a glorious invitation. A glorious invitation. An invitation that is excellent. An invitation that is splendid. An invitation that is illustrious. We shall look at this invitation and glean from the Bible the word of God concerning the person who calls and the ones to whom he is calling. And so as we consider this glorious invitation, the songwriter puts it sweetly and graciously. A glorious invitation now calls you to the feast. Each soul is now invited, the greatest and the least. Come all ye heavy burdened with sorrow or with care. Today you are invited, your burden Christ will bear. The Spirit says come, the bride says come. Let him that heareth say come, let him that is athirst come, and whosoever will, let him take of the water of life freely. What an invitation, what a marvelous truth. Come now, says the eternal God. And so the songwriter also says, come every soul, by sin oppressed, there's mercy with the Lord, and he will surely give thee rest by trusting in his word. Only trust him, only trust him, only trust him now. He will save thee, he will save thee, he will save thee now. So as we consider this glorious invitation, the first thing that comes to our minds is the one who calls. The one who calls. Who is the one who calls? The word of God says, come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. The one who calls is the Lord. Jehovah, Jehovah, the great I am, the one without beginning and the one without ending, the one who is immortal, invisible, God only wise, the one who dwells in light that is inaccessible to men. Not only does he dwell in light, but he is light personified. He is the light of the world. So the one who calls is Jehovah, and he calls you this day. And so it is not us who are calling, it is God, the great I am, who has called and who is calling. So the word of God says, come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. The one who calls is Jehovah, the great I am. Not only is he Jehovah, but the word of God wants us to know that the one who calls is just. He is just. He is upright. He is righteous. There is none like him. This is the one who called Israel unto himself. And this is the one who is calling you this morning. He is calling you today. And because there is not a greater who can call the sinner to be saved, we beg of you in the name of Jesus that you come while the Savior in mercy is waiting and stare for the harbor light. For how do you know but your soul may be drifting over the deadline today? The one who calls is Jehovah. The one who calls is just. There is none like him. Not only is he just, but the one who calls is judicious. He is prudent. He is wise. He is the all-wise God. The Bible tells us Solomon was wise. And apart from Jesus, Solomon was the wisest. But when we think of wisdom, when we think of this glorious person who calls and who called, there is none as wise as God. And so he calls you, friends, and he calls you today. The one who calls is Jehovah. The one who calls is just. The one who calls is judicious. He is wise. He is the all-wise God. The one who calls is the one who justifies the man, justifies the sinner who repents of his sins and turns to God through Christ. He is the one who justifies. The Bible tells us, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. He justifies the sinner. He declares the sinner as righteous. When the sinner repents of his sin and turns to God through Christ, he is declared righteous. God clothes him with his own righteousness, and no more does God see him in his sin. He sees him in Christ, and the Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. The one who calls is Jehovah. The one who calls is just. The one who calls is judicious. The one who calls justifies the sinner who repents. Secondly, not only the one who calls, but the order of the call. The Bible tells us of the order. Look at the order with us, please. The word of God says, come now and let us reason together. The order of the call. The order has a theme. There is a theme. What is the theme? Why does God call? He calls because he loves the sinner. He called Israel because he loved Israel with an everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness, he called her. And friends, today, friends, this morning, as we speak to you, as you view this broadcast, Moments with Truth, the theme is, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. God loves every sinner in Tobago. God loves every person in this island. God loves every person in this great nation, the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. God loves all our visitors who are on this island, all our visitors in this country. He loves everyone in the Caribbean. He loves everyone on this earth. God loves you. He calls you because he loves you. And friends, he wants to tell you, God hates your sin, but he loves the sinner. Oh, we trust today that as God calls you, and the theme is God loves you with an everlasting love, that you will take heed and come to the Savior, says the songwriter. Come to the Savior, make no delay. Here in his word, he has shown us the way. Here in our midst, he's standing today, tenderly saying, come. Joyful, joyful will the meeting be when from sin our hearts are pure and free, and we shall gather, Savior, with thee in our eternal home. Friends, God calls you because he loves you. The theme is God is love. What a God. Not only the theme, but we want you to observe that when we think of the theme, God is love. God's love is clean. God's love is pure. Absolutely pure. It's not like the love we have today. God's love is the agape love. What a love. The word of God makes it very, very clear. But God commendeth his own love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. God is love. God's love is clean. God's love is constant, unchanging. It cannot be changed because God is immutable. And because God is immutable, God's love is also immutable. It is constant. He loves you and would always love you, but he will hate every sin, and all sins God hates. So why not listen to our invitation? The invitation goes out from God to you. Come now and let us reason together. God's love is clean. God's love is constant. God's love is communicated, is revealed. God's love is revealed through Christ. Christ revealed the Father. He that had seen me had seen the Father. And so Jesus came into this world, lived a perfect life, and revealed unmistakably that the Godhead loves the sinner. The Father loves you. God the Father loves you. The Spirit loves you. And Jesus loves you. And that is why he went to Calvary and laid his life down. That is why this songwriter says, when I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, my richest gain I count but loss, and my poor contempt and all my pride. Love so amazing, so divine, demands my life, my soul, my all in all. God's love is clean. God's love is constant. God's love is communicated, revealed through the Lord Jesus Christ. Notice also the order. Not only has a theme, but it has a time. God says, come now. Come now. There is a time. God calls you, dear friends. He called Israel to himself, and he says, now. Not tomorrow, not next week, not next year. Israel, come now. And dear friends in this island, dear citizens, dear nationals, dear visitors of this great country, the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, God has a time, and he calls you to him now. Why does God say now? Why did God say now? Because one out of two things can take place. One, you can die at any moment. Death is coming, and the judgment day. The songwriter says, hasten sinner, seek the narrow way. God says now, because you can die at any moment. You don't know when you are going to die. I don't know when I'm going to die. And because neither of us knows, God says, come now, repent of your sin and turn to God through Christ. Not only does God want you to know that the time is now, because you can die at any moment, the other truth is Jesus can come at any moment. The Lord can come at any time. Before this broadcast, Moments with Truth comes to an end, the one who has promised to come can come. We are not setting dates, but we are telling you that there is no prophecy to be fulfilled in order for Jesus to come. Jesus can come at any moment. Jesus is coming. Sing the glad word. Coming for those he redeemed with his blood. Coming to reign as the glorified Lord. Jesus is coming again. It may be at midnight. It may be at twilight. It may be perchance that the blackness of midnight may burst into light, like a halo of glory when Jesus receives his own. He can come at any moment. And so God says, come now. Will you come now? Our heart's desire and prayer to God is that you will come now. The time is now. Not only the theme, not only the time, but please observe that the target, to whom is this invitation directed? It was directed to Israel, and this invitation has a target today. It is targeted to you as an individual. It is targeted to you as families. It's targeted to you, every person who is viewing this broadcast, Moments with Truth. God says to you, come now. You are the target, the one to whom the invitation is targeted. Come now and let us reason together. This invitation, the order is thorough. It is complete. It is entire. You don't have to add to it. You cannot add to it. God says come, and he means come, and he wants you to come, and he wants you to come now. Notice the truth. The order has truth. Notice what the Bible says. Come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, the Bible gives us the truth about sin. Your sins. Friends, we want you to observe that God speaks the truth and always does and will always do. He speaks, will always declare the truth about sin. Sin is the problem, and so many people don't want to hear about sin, but the Bible tells us about sin. God declares many things against sin, and as God, as we are alive, and as this broadcast continues to come, we will always declare the truth against sin. God hates sin. And God must judge sin. And God will judge sin. And if you don't repent of your sin, you will die and go to hell. The truth about sin. Friends, the Bible says, though your sin, that is the problem. The problem we have in Trinidad and Tobago is sin. Whatever the things are, whatever the other difficulties are in this country, we want to let you know that the bottom line is sin. And because of sin, men and women, boys and girls will be engaged in those things that are grievous in the sight of men and grievous in the sight of God. They will continue to hurt men because of sin. God wants you to recognize what sin does and what sin will do if you don't repent of your sin. Though your sin, the problem is sin. Though your sins be as scarlet, scarlet is brilliant red. And this color tells us that sin is incurable as far as man is concerned. There is no cure for sin. We have many great doctors in the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. We have many great doctors in the world, but no one has ever and will ever find the remedy for sin among men. Dear friends, I want to tell you, the remedy for sin is not water. The remedy for sin are not good works. The remedy for sin is not religion. The remedy for sin is the blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son. It still cleanses from sin. Sin is incurable. There is no human cure for sin. What can wash away your stain? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other font I know, nothing but the blood of Jesus. The songwriter also says, blessed be the fountain of blood to a world of sinners revealed. Blessed be the dear Son of God. Only by his stripes are we healed. Though we wandered far from his fold, bring into my heart pain and woe. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Whiter than snow, whiter than snow. Wash me in the blood of the Lamb, and I shall be whiter than snow. Sin is incurable, but the blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son, still has the power to cleanse from sin. Scarlet tells us that sin is incurable. Not only scarlet, but it says, it shall be like crimson, though your sins be like crimson. Crimson is deep red, and sin is internal. It comes from the inside and works its way on the outside. Dear friends, I want to tell you that sin is a disease. There are many diseases in the world, many diseases in this island, many diseases in this country, but the greatest disease is sin. God wants to save you, and he wants to save you now. Friends, we want to tell you about the sacrifice. You cannot talk about cleansing without the sacrifice. And this is the purpose for which Christ came into this world. God says, come unto me. He says, come, because he has made provision. The provision is his wonderful Son. In the days of Israel, lambs, a lamb was brought without blemish and slain. But he wanted to tell you of the Lamb of God. Jesus Christ came into this world. He laid his life down, the just for us, the unjust, to bring us to God. He died, was buried, is risen from the dead, and he is the only one who saves from sin. Do your sins be as scarlet? Do your sins be like crimson? You will be saved if you repent of your sin and trust him as your Savior. What will you do this day? Will you come? Will you come with your poor broken heart, burdened with sin oppressed, laid down at the feet of the Savior and Lord? Jesus will give you rest. The Word of God says, come now and let us reason together. Will you come? God is calling. God is calling now. We trust that as you have listened to it, Do not reject it. Receive Jesus.
Thank you for viewing today's broadcast, Moments with Truth. We want to invite you to call us at 796-0979 or 283-2222. Or you can email us at afrob64@gmail.com. If you look on the screen, you will see our various locations and the times of our services. Be free to attend. A welcome awaits you at all times.